My name is John, I'm a postie and I run on hydropower.
My previous knowledge of hydro is just big, huge hydroelectric schemes that they have all over the Highlands. Small-scale hydro, I think, was all new to me, and that's the way I went, and I've never regretted it.
Yes, when I took over this job, all I had was an old-fashioned push bike. I hassled the van out of them. I was the first just to get a postman. Now, first class is 126.
Perfect. Thank you very much, John.
You're very welcome.
That was in 1979 I came to Eigg, which was 36 years ago. Bloody hell. If you had electricity at all, most people had diesel generators. Well, they're expensive to buy, they're expensive to maintain. Until I got my hydro, I didn't have any electricity at all.
The basic technology of my main hydro, the turbine, hasn't changed much, and although I've gone through a couple of turbines, it basically does what it started out doing.
What makes this such an ideal spot for a hydro is that this barn here is fed by three separate springs which come up there. When the water table gets high, this water will keep flowing for easily a month without any rain. Got the filter, goes into this catchment area here, which is 8-inch pipe, which goes to the top of the bank, heading straight down towards the sea. And then it goes down a bit to 6-inch pipe. The turbine is actually just this little bit under the green barrel. This is just a box with mainly with capacitors in it. This is the main turbine where it goes in and narrows down into a fine nozzle which spins the doings, to use the technical term.
The electricity comes from the turbine to the house by way of 240 metres of electric cable.
Okay, see ya.
I'm very aware of the power is coming through water pressure. It's up to me to make sure it keeps running. I'm proud that I don't use too much in the way of fossil fuels, and I think it would be good if we could all cut down on our carbon consumption, even if it's just a little bit.